This video was published by mbkpinternational.com. In this video, we're going to talk about the XPC 19 Pro and replacing the top clamp gear. First thing you want to do is remove the side screws from the crown. There's two there, two on the other side. I've already done it. And also the four screws that hold this back cover on. One, two, three, four, one in each quarter. Just slide this back once you get those screws out, about an inch, just to clear this lip. And then we're going to take this crown after removing the two screws on each side. And straight up, it will unplug itself from that board right there. It is plugged in right there, and you'll plug it back in there when you put that. And what we're going to be replacing is this top gear here. And this is basically if this gear locks up. And you should still be able to turn it if it locks up. What I mean by locking up is, you can see it. These are supposed to have play in it. See, this is the bottom part of the gear, and this is the top part. I'm going to hold this so it doesn't move. You can see that white dot there. It's supposed to have this 360 degree play in it before it hits and starts turning the whole thing. And if yours doesn't have that, then it's locked up, and if it goes down to the bottom, a lot of times it will get stuck because the motor needs that play to basically give it a running start to break this thing free. So the first thing you're going to do is a lot of times your clamp will already be at the bottom, and we're going to take this, we'll take this belt off first here and just lift up on it and rotate. Just don't get your fingers caught in there. Lift up and rotate, lift up and rotate. You can do it from either side, whichever way turns easier for you. And now we're going to remove this here. Go ahead and pause it and look at the tools. Okay, I got this. Is, in this case, it's a 4mm hex. I've seen it different. Sometimes they're, but just go ahead and start turning this. I guess as you're looking down on it, be counterclockwise until the clamp goes. If you got it up like this, you want to just go down. Otherwise, someone's gonna have to hold this to try to break this nut free or bolt. So get it all the way down, and that way it won't go anymore, and you'll be able to break it free from the top here eventually. That one's on pretty tight. They're usually not that tight, but that one came off. I'm just gonna take this off here. And now, sometimes these things will pull. See this one here? It's going to pull right off. You don't need a gear puller for it. But sometimes these things are stiff, and you need a gear puller to pull it off. Now, I'm just going to get a gear puller and show you what it's like, just in case you need it. Okay. You could. It depends on the way yours is. This one's got a point, and it would go down into these threads, and tip. It could mess up the threads. So I'm going to put this screw back in, so this part doesn't go in there and mess up the threads in this thing. Screwed in several turns if you have to do the same thing. And then basically you're just gonna put this thing on. Huh? Put that in the center of the bolt. Loosen this down until you get all those under there. Okay. You can look at this thing and should be all under it there. This one's in the wrong spot. Let me pause this and fix this here. Hold on. Okay, got it back on this gear pole. It wasn't adjusted correctly, but just get these all underneath here, and then you're just gonna use a socket or something or a wrench to just turn the. Obviously, this one ain't very tight, so I can do this one by hand. But if it was tight, you would need some kind of socket or wrench to slowly start pulling this off like this, and eventually you get to a point where you can take it all the way off. Okay, your gear and this your Just make sure this stays there. You got that that key on the back here. Make sure that stays in there. And now, again, these should separate, and it should have, as you can see, it should go back and forth like that. And I got another one here. You can put new one on like this. Yeah. And see, this one's a little bit tighter, it feels like, but so. So it'd have to be new. I can just go ahead and this one right here. Let's just, since it's going back on it, let's put it back on. If it didn't go on easy like that, you can just tap it with. You can get like either a rubber mallet and tap it on. Once you get it centered and get it on that key, you got that key slot. You got to watch for. And you can even do it without this. They separate. You got to keep those little rubbers on each side of it though. Okay. Anyway, just put it on. You can tap it with a rubber hammer to get it down on there. You can separate the two, or you can just do it like this. It doesn't really matter. Or if you don't have a rubber, you can use a regular hammer and put a block of wood over it. Just tap it on there good. We'll go ahead and put this one back here. And then you're just basically gonna replace everything. You put your, you're gonna take your screw back out because I put that in there to pull it off. And then just put that back in, tighten that back. Now when you go to tighten this down, it's gonna be just the opposite. You're gonna, it's gonna help break it free from the bottom for one. And then it'll come up, but to tighten it, you need to come all the way up with it to get a good tightening on it. You could hold it with your hand and tighten it, but I just like going all the way up. Then it won't go, as soon as you top out, it won't go anymore. Then you can put a little torque on this because you want this pretty tight to, so it doesn't ever come loose. And then from there, you need to back it off by hand because you want this down a little bit below the blade, like maybe half an inch below the blade, the top of the blade. And then from there, you just reverse the process. You can hook this back here, start it on, and just, sorry about that, get that on there, and just start pulling it around like that. Just don't get your fingers, skin or anything caught there. And then you're just gonna put your crown back on. You just need to make sure you get that, there's a, you get your cable here. That's for your, that's your data wire for your display screen. You just gotta make sure you get it, have someone plug it in there when you're putting it back on. Just get it plugged in good. And put all your screws back in, put your shield back on, and that should be, you can, you, if you want, you can test it before you put the crown on. I just plug it in and do that. You can move this out of the way. And just make sure your shield's kind of in place, not hanging down or anything, because it'll hit this. If there's no crown on, the paper push, depends on where you have it, it's going to go all the way to the back because it doesn't know where to go since the crown's off. And it's going to go all the way back and stay there. Wait 5-10 seconds for it to do that before you do a cut. But from there, you can just do a cut here. Again, you start with the clamp up. Make sure it's a little below the, below your blade, and just do a cut. And that's basically it. This video was published by mbkpinternational.com.